Hello everyone, welcome back to this yet another edition of the Cafe IPL show that we've recently started for the IPL 2021 playoffs. Today we'll be previewing the eliminator of IPL 2021, which is going to take place between Royal Challengers Bangalore and Kolkata Knight Riders at the Sharjah Cricket Stadium. Tonight we'll be having this game in Sharjah, where the pitches have turned tricky ever since the team stepped onto the field on the very first day of IPL 2021 UAE leg. We have Addy along with us to discuss today's match preview. Addy, I warmly welcome you on behalf of Cricket Addictor.
Thank you, Priyam. And yes, guys, so we have witnessed the first match of this playoff, the all-important qualifier, where we saw pretty unexpectedly, actually. I personally thought DC was winning after the first half of the game, but we have Chennai Super Kings, and most importantly for me, I was very happy to see MSD back in form, and so did Virat Kohli congratulate his former captain on social media. Today, as Priyam said, we have Kolkata and RCB. Kolkata, who have been a force to be reckoned with so far in the IPL since we have shifted to UAE. So Priyam, just a sort of analysis that you could do on KKR, on their batting. They have a new batting talent there. So any thoughts you have on their performance in the second half of the IPL?
They've been phenomenal. I've been the only team that has looked dominant apart from Delhi Capitals in the UAE leg, because although Chennai Super Kings were on a winning streak, but they lost three consecutive matches. So apart from Delhi Capitals and Chennai Super Kings, the only side that has looked dominant in this UAE leg has been Kolkata Knight Riders for sure. I mean, what a turnaround it has been for them. I remember that coming into the UAE leg, Dinesh Karthik stated that their aim is to win 6 out of 7 games, and they did exactly that. The only loss that came to them in the form of Chennai Super Kings when they faced each other in Abu Dhabi. So I believe they've been a very good side, a very good batting unit, and what a bowling unit they've got. I mean, two very good spinners in the form of Varun Chakravarti and Sunil Narayan, who've scripted the show so far for Kolkata Knight Riders in this year's IPL. And then adding to the pace battery is Loki Ferguson, who's been magnificent with the ball in this year's IPL. Addy, speaking about the Kolkata Knight Riders batting lineup, as I mentioned, Venkatesh Iyer, he's a star in the making, I believe. Yeah. Such calmness, such composure to his game. Every time he steps onto the field, he can contribute with the bat, the ball, and on the field as well. How crucial do you think will he be tonight in Kolkata's journey to make it to the second qualifier?
Of course, Priyam, very important, and I am always excited to see young players such as Venkatesh Iyer and Gaikwad, as we saw yesterday. So it's a very good performance from him to in the second half of the IPL. I particularly liked that innings where he had scored that half century, and he was amongst one of the only players in the KKR squad in that match who had a very respectable innings. So yeah, it's all been building up. Kolkata looks like a well-oiled machinery now, and Venkatesh Iyer seems to be a very integral part of that. And it'll be very interesting, and I hope for him and for the KKR squad, and obviously for the captain who has had a slow run with the bat, that Venkatesh really steps up to the platter. He performs at the biggest cricket league qualifier in his, probably the biggest T20 domestic league match of his career. So I expect a lot from him today, along with Nitish and Shubman. So it's really great to see a bunch of domestic talent towards the younger spectrum of the cricket age group really come out and perform. I would love to see at least two or maybe all three of these young domestic batsmen really carry their batting order. So Priyam, I thought I'd also ask you along the batting order, that one dominant, brutal, you know, hitter, Russell, he was out injured, but he is expected to make a comeback here. So whose place do you think? I personally think that Shakib may be given a rest and we might see the Russell muscle come in. What do you think?
Absolutely, no question about it. Because, see, they can't replace Owen Morgan, and we've seen that throughout all these games, he's been leading the side, although his personal form is very down. But at the moment, Kolkata Knight Riders seem to persist with their captain. As far as Andre Russell is concerned, I believe that if he is set to make a comeback, it will definitely be in place of Shakib Al-Hasan. Unfortunately, Shakib Al Hasan has to miss out, but I believe he's a very genuine all-rounder. But since the conditions in Sharjah support a bit of a bowler who comes up with some sort of variations in the bowling unit, so I believe that Andre Russell can provide that flair to them. Absolutely, he was phenomenal with the ball in the first leg of the IPL. That performance against Mumbai Indians, if we have to remember, he was scintillating with the ball. So I believe that yes, definitely he can come in if he's fit and ready to go. But Kolkata Knight Riders once again would not like to risk him in such an important situation, because if he's not fully fit for tonight's game and they risk him tonight and he gets injured, even if then Kolkata Knight Riders manage to win, they'll be without a crucial asset in the second qualifier. So I believe a very important decision from Kolkata Knight Riders' perspective. It'll be interesting to see if he makes it into the playing 11 tonight. Now, Addy, speaking about you spoke about the Kolkata Knight Riders younger boys going all guns ablaze in this year's tournament. But what about Owen Morgan, the captain himself? It's a famous saying that you have to lead from the front whenever you are playing a sport, whenever you are playing a team sport, whenever you are leading the side. But as far as Owen Morgan is concerned, his personal form is on a very lowest scale, is on a very lowest point at the moment. So how high a time do you think it is for Owen Morgan to perform tonight and set the example, set the tone for his team?
Yeah, Priyam, I couldn't agree with you more. And I, when you asked me that, actually, I remembered that meme by Cricket Addictive, that post more rather, saying that extras were actually almost double of Owen Morgan's runs in the six innings. So yes, exactly. That pretty much sums up the unfortunate run the English and KKR's skipper has had. But at the same time, Priyam, before I come to his batting performance and the importance of his batting performance in this pretty big game, I should also point out that there is probably something that Owen Morgan, not as a batsman, but as a leader and a cricketer, is doing right. Because it's his team, his unit that he's led, which has this outstanding performance in this league. You know, 6 out of 7 wins in the second half of the IPL. So, yes, it's very great to see that he is leading his team. And, you know, a lot of the credit could go on the individual performances of the team. But they are Morgan knows about all the decisions and he probably anticipated most of the outcomes. We don't personally know how they came out. But, yeah, there is something that he is doing right as a leader. And coming on that, you know, Priyam, yesterday only we saw our MSD after a reasonably dry run with the bat as compared to, you know, the explosion we've seen from him in the earlier years. Maybe the playoffs are a platform that we would see the skippers just come and perform with their mind and with their bat. You know, I hope to see Owen Morgan get a 30-plus score today, simply for his confidence and for the entire team's confidence. And so, Priyam, also, I thought that we should also shift our focus to the RCB batting. One interesting thing I found that perhaps the encounter could be between KKR spinners, Varun Chakraborty, Sunil Narine, two very intriguing mystery spinners against the RCB batting. You know, so any comments on how you think the RCB batting will combat this mighty spin force of the KKR?
See, as far as the RCB batting lineup is concerned, I believe that their top order hasn't been that solid, especially Virat Kohli and Devdutt Padikkal. Yes, they've got starts in some matches, but they have failed to convert those starts into big innings. So, I believe that today, once again, a KKR's captain, Owen Morgan, will be thinking of applying these spinners from the very first over in the very first power play itself. So, it can be a crucial battle between the KKR spinners and the RCB openers. Virat Kohli hasn't been able to play the spinners that well in this year's IPL, and that's a fact, and that needs to be taken into account, especially considering that the T20 World Cup is on the brink in the coming days. So, as far as the spinners are concerned, I believe from the RCB batting perspective, Glenn Maxwell will be very crucial to their chances of outperforming KKR spinners, because he has been exceptional with the bat this year's IPL. The faith that they have imposed on Glenn Maxwell, he's completely reposed that faith, I believe. And see what a turnaround a situation can bring. We saw that Glenn Maxwell had been struggling with his bat in the IPL ever since he played for Kings 11 Punjab, now Punjab Kings. Because he was not given that confidence by the management. He was always demoted down the order. He was not allowed to play in his favorite batting position. And now that he has shifted to RCB and RCB has respected his batting position, his choices, he has always made sure that he gives his 100% to the team. So I believe that for tonight, if RCB look to outplay the KKR spinners, Glenn Maxwell's performance will be very crucial, and apart from him, Shrikar Bharat has also been exceptional with the bat at number 3 for RCB, because even Virat Kohli might not agree with the fact, but yes, there has been a conundrum for the number 3 batting position in RCB's batting lineup, especially over the last couple of years. So I believe they found a solid option in the form of Shrikar Bharat. And Shrikar Bharat and Glenn Maxwell will once again be the key for the RCB batting lineup as far as tonight's game is concerned. Now coming to the middle order of Royal Challengers Bangalore, Addy, I believe they've been somewhat smart in promoting Glenn Maxwell up the order, but on the same note, they've been very foolish to, you know, send a batsman like AB de Villiers at number 6. I mean, Dan Christian is coming out to bat at number 3 in some games, and you give 12 or 13 deliveries to a guy like AB de Villiers, who can turn the match on its head on his day. So what do you think? Do they need to promote AB de Villiers if they are in a clutch situation in tonight's game?
Yeah, Priyam, I couldn't agree with you more. Like the Dan Christian instance that you pointed out, that was a pretty big error on the team management side, because those kind of errors, I don't think, should be made in a match of this importance, simply because you need your best batters on their top morale, their top performance, their top confidence. So yes, AB, definitely, I think number 4 is a perfect position for him, but the way that the management thinks is, I don't know if similar or different, but it's yet to be seen. And Glenn Maxwell, you know, I am personally all right with his batting position, but one or two up or down, you could tell me how he could be better. But, you know, 498 runs, and there was this thing that, you know, similar to how petrol prices go up, Glenn Maxwell's price has been going up in the auction. And this is the first time since, I think, 2014, when he had that outstanding run for Punjab in UAE, that he's had a really good run with RCB, almost nearing 500 runs now. And he is one of those players, Priyam, I think, that when he is at his best form, he is meant for a league like IPL, because he got that slugger attitude with the bat. You got outstanding fielding and, of course, the part-time bowling and an outstanding international cricketer as well. And I like the varying in these top three players. You know, you got Virat Kohli with the class. He can get those nice fours, those twos, and AB can both go slugging, and he can play like Kohli and Maxwell, as we know his performance so far. So yeah, AB and Maxwell, I think that at least one of them needs to fire. And regarding their positions, Priyam, maybe their position in the batting order, maybe you could also shed some light on that.
Yeah, I personally believe that Glenn Maxwell is a perfect choice for number 4. He's been doing very, very good at that batting position, and as far as AB de Villiers is concerned, he should come right after Glenn Maxwell, I believe, because you don't want that attacking flair to stop any time in that innings. If Glenn Maxwell and Shrikar Bharat have provided you that momentum, you need to carry it on from the next delivery itself. You can't wait for the opposition to take the game away from you. So I also believe that definitely Glenn Maxwell should bat at 4 and AB de Villiers should come at number 5. Now coming to the RCB all-round department, and I believe Harshal Patel, what a find he has been this season for Team India and for the Royal Challengers Bangalore as well. I am personally very much excited to see as to what the Indian selection committee does with him, especially considering Hardik Pandya's form. He can be a really crucial asset in the UAE conditions for Team India in the ICC T20 World Cup. He's on a very special brink in tonight's game. Dwayne Bravo holds the record of taking the most wickets in a single IPL season, having clinched 32 wickets, and Harshal Patel has already clinched 30 wickets in this year's tournament. So if he manages to surpass more than 2 wickets in tonight's game, he will be the all-time leading wicket taker in a single season in the IPL. So Addy, how high are your hopes from Harshal Patel in tonight's game?
Yeah, Priyam, obviously it goes without saying when someone would see the highest wicket takers, the purple cap list, they would see Harshal Patel on top, overtaking 3 top tier international bowlers and obviously this year's sensation Avesh Khan. But more importantly, Priyam, I think that I should also point out that Harshal Patel in the first half of the IPL has obviously had amazing success, but he has seen the lowest point and he has seen a highest point. He has picked up, I believe, 5 wickets in a match in the first part of the IPL.
Yeah.
But at the same time, he was also thrashed for over 30 runs at the bat of Ravindra Jadeja. So it's good that he got that gap and the IPL was given that, gap and done again in September so that he can evaluate his performance so far. You know, he can look back at his high points, his low points and come up with a plan for this very crucial match. Maybe he can, give some nice variations, change it up, stick to his basics. I do really hope that he gets 2 or 3 wickets today simply because the Indian Premier League can then have an Indian domestic bowler hold the record. So yeah, that is something I'm really hoping for. And anything you want to add to Harshal and other bowlers that we would be seeing from RCB today?
Absolutely. I believe another important bowler for RCB in tonight's game can be Yuzvendra Chahal, because the dimensions are very small, but Yuzvendra Chahal's stature is too big. I believe Rahul Chahar was selected in place of Yuzvendra Chahal, and when the selectors got that opportunity, they said that they wanted a spinner who could bowl quicker through the air. And now that we are in the playoff stages of the IPL, we've seen that Rahul Chahar wasn't backed by his own franchise. I mean, Mumbai Indians benched him for 3 or 4 games straight. And on the contrary, Yuzvendra Chahal has picked up his form ever since coming into the UAE leg. So I believe that tonight, Yuzvendra Chahal will once again be very ferocious with the ball. He is in a mood to give an answer or to make a statement to the selectors that yes, the old Yuzvendra Chahal has gone nowhere and he can still do magic with the ball. He has been India's highest wicket taker in T20 internationals, and that in itself is something, a very big achievement to look out for. So if the RCB bowling lineup is concerned, I believe that Yuzvendra Chahal, and apart from him, obviously what a turnaround these last couple of years have been for Mohammad Siraj as well. As a bowler, he has grown from strength to strength. In the death overs, the amount of yorkers that he delivers, and that too slower yorkers. I mean, delivering yorkers in itself is a very, very hard skill to acquire, and delivering slower yorkers is even harder. So I believe that that Mohammad Siraj has mastered that skill, and that in itself shows how keen he is to learn and grow. He's taken up that role for Team India in Test cricket. So tonight I believe that Harshal Patel, Mohammad Siraj and Yuzvendra Chahal, this trio will once again be very, very crucial for RCB's domination in this game. And on that note, I would like to take a concluding remark from you, Addy. Coming to the spinners, the spin duo of Varun Chakravarti and Sunil Narayan, how crucial do you think are they going to be tonight against Royal Challengers Bangalore?
Yeah, Priyam, very crucial. But before I get into that for a minute, I would just like to point out, since we're on the concluding remark, that KKR have the highest total in this part of the IPL in UAE, in Sharjah Stadium. Sorry, beg your pardon. A slower track this year. So yes, the RCB bowlers, in my opinion, have a bigger challenge to face. Coming to the KKR bowling, Priyam, as we said earlier, that it's probably their spinners against the RCB batsmen. So yes, the primary concentration will be on the young talent Varun Chakravarti and the veteran Sunil Narayan. They have to complement and supplement each other's bowling. They have to come up and work together as a unit on how to crack down on the RCB batsmen. You know, what variations to use, how exactly to bowl to which bowler, and bowl as per the pace that the RCB batting are in that part of the game, whether it's power play or after that. So it's going to be very interesting, very intriguing to see how they are going to try to stop, obviously, Glenn Maxwell and his other two comrades, his captain, Virat Kohli. And I personally hope that RCB win this game simply because it's Virat Kohli's last year of captaincy. Any concluding remarks from your end, PM?
Absolutely. I believe that it'll be once again a thrilling encounter as we witnessed yesterday. What a game of cricket did we see. In the very last over, MS Dhoni finished it off once again. And I believe only MS Dhoni can do it like the way he does it in world cricket at the moment. Another match to look out for. Very strong sides. I believe Royal Challengers Bangalore, Kolkata Knight Riders, they've got all it takes to make it to the second qualifier. Let's hope for the best team to win tonight, and let's hope for another thrilling encounter and a game to witness for the spectators. That's all for today's show, Addy. Thank you so much for joining in. And we'll be continuing with this series of episodes, and we'll see you in the second qualifier episode. Thank you so much.
Thank you.